So I want to start off by asking, how many of you like to travel? Great. How many of you have traveled internationally before? That's awesome. Okay, so I've only traveled internationally in France, but since then I've had just this great passion for French culture and for the French people themselves. So I wanted to share some of these passions with you guys. So to start off, I want to share some similarities between French culture and our American culture. The weather and climate is actually very similar to our entire East Coast. So this is southern France. It's very colorful buildings. There's a beach, so it's kind of like Florida all year round. You know, it's warm and sunny. But in northern France, there's more stone structures like this. And it's more like my home, New York. So it's like got the four seasons, can be cold in the wintertime, but it's still beautiful all the same. Another similarity is pop culture. So they have the same dances, same songs, same movies over there. They do have their French artists as well, but they really like to like be more American by listening to American stuff. It's kind of funny though, because here we get everything pretty much instantly, but over there, like, they get it slower than we get here. So like when the Wicked Nene was a big thing over here, it like kind of ended, and then when we went there, it was just starting. So like everyone thought it was like the new thing. We're like, nah, like that's done. Education is another big similarity. So that's it's a first world country, so they take a big part in putting their kids through the education system. However, this kind of leads to the differences. Not all the students go through high school and continue. At the end of their senior year, they have to actually take a test called the BAC or the Baccalaureat. And if they don't pass that test, then they don't graduate from high school. So going into the differences, there are shops. Like the shops are a lot different over there because they don't have department stores and huge grocery stores. Everything is like much smaller. So here you have Boulangerie, which is a bread shop. And they have fromageries, which is a cheese shop, pâtisseries, pastry shops. Everything's just smaller. And a large part of that is because they make everything fresh every day. And also, they close all their shops on Sundays because a large part of French culture is Catholicism. So even though, like, they'll say they're Catholics, but honestly, they don't even go to church. But it's been such a large part of their culture, they still say it anyway. And that's why they closed on Sundays. Going into the food is huge over there. It's a different kind of huge though. Like here, it's if you eat a ton of food, like that's great. But there, it's about the quality and no preservatives and portion sizes. So it's just greater quality there. Also, going into preservatives into health. So health is sort of a big deal over there. Well, it is a big deal over there. Instead of like driving everywhere, they like to walk, they like to bike. In fact, oh, I have to mention this. So, back to the food. They have the regular three courses a day, breakfast, lunch, and dinner. But for breakfast, all they eat is like bread. It's croissants, baguettes, crepes, everything like that. It's really nice. For lunch, it's a little bit simple. It's like either quiche or salad or something small. And then dinner, same thing, it's small, it's like a little portion of meat, some potatoes, and they'll always have a dessert, but it's not like triple chocolate dessert that we'll have here. It's like creme brulee, which is light and fluffy and easy to eat after a small dinner. So back to the health. So the picture I have here is a bike station, and they have bike stations all throughout France. Like, especially in Paris, you can travel from one part of the city to another part just by using those transporting bikes. And they're pretty much like public transportation. Finally, I'm going to discuss some signatures of France. So wine is huge over there. It's not necessarily about the alcohol part. It's about the cultural experience of having wine with dinner or having wine with guests. It's just a culturally accepted thing. Also, lavender is very well known over there. So they have lavender fields, and especially in southern France, it's more of a Provence style thing, which Provence is one of the provinces there. They'll have sachets, which are little bags filled with lavender, and you can just put those around your house and they make your house smell really nice. So, in conclusion, I believe that French culture is worth experiencing and worth learning about. I hope I shared a few facts with you guys today that piqued your interest in it all.